Renovations to an old English pub revealed an object hidden for centuries. If you've thrown salt over your shoulder or lifted your legs when driving over train tracks, guess what? You're a little superstitious. No need to sweat, you're not alone. People have been committing little rituals to ward off the bad, evil, or plain made up for thousands of years. Every once in a while, the evidence of humans' feeble attempts at protection resurface years later. The renovation of a historic English home was interrupted after workers found a strange-looking bottle wedged in the fireplace. No one dared uncork the thing for fear of the unknown, but a closer look by experts revealed the vial as a fascinating bit of leftover superstition. It was a chimney-smashing day at the former Star and Garter Inn in Watford, Northamptonshire. The property was undergoing major renovations to bring the centuries-old brick building into the modern era until something tucked in the flue drive worked to a halt. Workers found, carefully hidden inside the chimney, a tiny soot-covered bottle with a fairly unusual torpedo shape. It was stoppered with wax, and the general strangeness of its location told the workers it was probably for the best to keep the thing sealed tightly shut. The current owner, who uses the space as a residential property, had no idea what the little bottle might be. But historians only needed to hear the details of the discovery to determine the purpose it served. Based on the age of the building, the English setting, and the obscurity of its placement, all signs pointed to the recovery of a witch bottle, and this wasn't the first. All across Great Britain, people were unearthing these little-known objects of the paranormal. Handling a witch bottle won't make your skin turn green or your hands wither. Actually, the concoctors hoped the creations would ward off the slightest whiff of a magical hijinks. Back when witch bottles were widely popular, they were used for protection. As you can imagine, the contents of the secret anti-witch potion weren't exactly a health drink. Each object placed in the bottle served a specific purpose. In the business of witch protection, each step closely resembled witchcraft itself. Inside the recovered bottle were a mixture of fish hooks, bits of glass, and human teeth, swimming together in a bath of mystery liquid. The ingredients closely resembled other recovered vials scattered across the country, the common components to a witch bottle. It started with the liquid, which was usually urine. The person who feared the wrath of witchcraft used their own bodily fluids to lure potential darkness into the bottle. So if you find one of these beneath your floorboards, we suggest wearing gloves. Once drawn in by the urine, it was believed that the witches would be trapped by the sharp objects included in the bottle. Now, this is where the potion maker could flex their creative muscles. A dash of toenail clippings, several pins, a sprinkle of thorns, whatever sharp objects the maker had on hand worked just fine in the witch bottle. In some cases, swaths of human hair were added to entangle the devilish spirits. The Northampton discovery was among 100 other recovered witch bottles in Great Britain. Each one was a little bit different, from the symbolic ingredient selected to the hiding spot that the paranoid maker chose to stow their creation. The Museum of London Archaeology launched a 3-year research study on witch bottles, how they fit into the areas of actual medicine, and to what degree magic was involved. Mostly, they've learned about the patterns of superstition. During peak 17th century witch paranoia, people hid witch bottles and carved witch markings into the most commonly believed entry point, the fireplace. The chimney stack provided what historians call a deviant path, with the heat of the flames aiding entrapment. Oftentimes, people concealed the witch bottle in the farthest corner of the property. Some choose to bury their talismans of protection in the ground, while others just tuck them away, sight unseen, in unsuspecting areas of the home. According to BBC reports, as many as 300 people were executed for witchcraft in eastern England between 1644 and 1646. Witch fever started spreading in the 17th century, paranoia spanning continents, and was still rearing its head hundreds of years later. What left experts particularly curious about the creator of the Northampton witch bottle was the glass bottle itself. They determined it only traced back to the 1830s, long after public accusations of witchery had fallen out of fashion. People stopped pointing fingers crying witch, but fear lingered. The residents of the old house in Watford thought it necessary to put a witch bottle in the fireplace to ward off the spirit of a famous sorceress that had roots in that very home. Angeline Tubbs, otherwise known as the Witch of Saratoga, took her first breath in the Watford home back in 1761. Later, she made the voyage to America as a teen, where she established herself in upstate New York as a sorceress and fortune teller. From her home in the hills of Saratoga Springs, New York, Angeline provided locals with all their witchery needs. Thankfully, her status as a witch was a taboo curiosity among the community. Just 100 years before, it would have cost her life. After finding a bit of history in his property, the owner, who opted to remain unidentified, decided it best to keep the bottle in its intended home. He commented, "I'll probably hide it away again for someone to find in another 100 years or so." Whether that soul will know the meaning of their witchy discovery, who can be sure?